is yeah, welcome back again to the show with Akene. I'm Daniela Odunaya Ajayi, and this is the Knowledge Active Show. You guys can understand, like, I give you guys premium content, classic content. See, I've even gone to another region by giving you this again. How can you subscribe? How can you help this channel? It's by subscribing. Click that subscribe button. Trust me, you know the choke. Now let's try it. Click on the subscribe button. I'm counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now it choke you. No, you don't choke you. Two of this video is going to be lit back to back. And trust me, this is something we can all relate to. I attended a program sometimes back, and after I finished the program, I got so many critics from teenagers and people of my same age group. And I was wondering, like, okay, wait, why are there so many critics? Why did this topic bring so many critics? I was super surprised until I asked some people, and then we convert. And I was like, okay, yeah, this is a nice topic for me to talk about here, so that you guys can what enjoy and listen. So let's dive in into the content of today. Oh shit. What we talked about was kissing. Oh my god. Like, see, I know why growing up as a child, our parents be like, don't let anybody skip it to you, da-da-da-da-da. Nobody talks about the kissing part. So people felt like, oh yeah, it wasn't a crime. Actually, growing up, I didn't see it as a crime. Trust me, I did not see it as a crime. I thought it was just something normal. It's one of those useful exorbitants, so please, I should be way be restricted from doing it. But then, until my eyes got open to something interesting, get to 2 Timothy 2, verse 22. That verse alone was a mind blower. It blew me, then I was like, oh wow. So this was what our parents were trying to tell us about or talk to us about. But then they could not come down to our own level. Well, yeah, I am giving it to you. Free of charge. Did that ring a bell to you? Flee also youthful lust. Trust me. When I tell you that kissing happens to be one of youthful exorbitants and youthful lusts, it is part of it. Now listen, you might be like, okay, I've just kissed him, then I didn't have sex with him and everything. Yeah, you're very much correct, but trust me, when you're kissing somebody, your hands gotta be busy. You kiss somebody and put your hand at the back, nope, your hand is going to be very, very, very busy. So what am I trying to tell you? That kissing is a sin. Did I ring a bell? If you have any contrary, comment down in the comment section. Let me know what you think about it. Because me, I feel like, yeah, it's a sin. Because, yeah, I got the Bible. You already said, flee from any youthful lust. And one of the youthful lusts that I know of is kissing. Because kissing preempts sex. Mm. Something what mind-blowing. Resonate about it. That Bible verse commands us to flee from what? Any sign. It commands us to flee from any strong lust that comes with what? Youthful ages. Yeah, people will be like, yeah, it's just me being... just me enjoying my life, it's my emotions, my feelings and everything. Yeah, it's a good feeling, it's a good emotion. Everybody has emotions. I have emotions, you have emotions, but how we manage your emotions matters a lot. Do you also know that the Bible tells us that if you cannot withstand immorality, you should do what? Get married. See, when someone told me this, I was like, it's not in the Bible, until my eyes was open to that particular chapter. I'll tell you, because you already know, I don't come here and give you a fool. I give you substance. Say substance. Do not touch a man or do not touch a woman. Then it says flee from fornication. It says to avoid fornication, let each one have their own wife and their own husband. Please. Did that set it for you? Yeah, it did. It did. Because, see, me myself, I was touched and moved by this. Like, oh, wow. So kissing is actually a sin. Trust me, I never knew it was. Okay, so now that you know it, don't go about preaching this kind of thing, saying kissing is not a sin. It is a sin. So preach it to the world, even to the youngest of the children in your church, in fact in your environment, because they need to know that kissing is a sin. It preempts what? Sex. And one thing I will tell you to round off this thing is that, you know, the Bible also curses anyone who tries that kind of thing. You're like, wow, is it possible? Whoever allows another person to stumble. Maybe it's true, the person stumbled. Maybe the person did not even want to kiss you before or touch you before. But because of your paperempty, the person actually would fell into temptation. Then it says, woe unto you. Please don't be wooed. Okay? If there's anything like that, don't allow another person to stumble because of your act or your actions. It's actually a sin. Okay? If you know you cannot withstand it, if you know you cannot bear it, please, the Bible already told us, just like I said, the 1 Corinthians, it says, what? Get married, have your own wife, and have your own husband. I hope you guys enjoyed this particular video. I hope you guys have learned a lot. So if you think you have contributed about all these things I said, comment down in the comment section and let me know your thoughts. But basically, I've already told you what the scripture said about it. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And this is the Knowledge Active Show. Bye.